When I come into this building, I feel comfortable. It feels warm. It feels like a place I want to be.
The design of the building, the nature theme, is not only supportive of our students and their feeling of well-being and wellness, but also the staff, that when they walk through those doors, even just approaching the school, they get that sense of, I'm gonna be okay here, I'm gonna be safe.
Many of the children who are referred to our program from our member districts are young people who are experiencing some challenges that are really getting in the way of them accessing their educational program.
The schools that they were currently occupying didn't work because they were traditional schools. Well, it's kind of hard to understand what that means until you actually go into one of their schools and live a day with them.
In conventional school planning, you think of very linear, structured, double-loaded corridors. That is a real challenge for them, because with a straight linear axis, you have views to the outside. And there's this population, there are several that really will be distracted by a door or a window at the end of a hallway.
Kind of the rigid planning and construction of a traditional school really lended itself to the disruption of the entire school when one individual had a deregulating event.
When you start in a project like this, where there is no precedent, you can look and see what the existing facility is, but you know, we're adaptable. Teachers are, they're going to use the space the best they can. So that is an exciting process, going in to see what it is, how things work, how do these kids come to the site, what's the scariest part about coming to this school. For a lot of the kids, it's getting off the bus and going in the front door. And so we ask the right questions and get those answers, and then we start working with those specific answers. It's not going to really be a elementary school. It's not really a behavioral hospital. It's a combination of both of these things. And it wants to be a great learning environment, but you have to take into consideration the different behavioral aspects.
We wanted to do something different, something that was therapeutic for this population. And the design solution that we came up with through a series of tests was more conventional sheetrock walls with beautiful wood wainscot and accents of graphic panels and colors that become a warm, rich palette for the Karner Blue Educational Facility.
What we really wanted them to feel when they first came into the school is that it is a normal elementary school. It's not a specialty school.
As we started generating different ideas to relate to their needs for this series of transitional spaces, and then the separation of different populations, et cetera, we came up with three or four different models, and this pod concept kind of emerged from that.
And if you look at this plan, the plan looks like nothing you've ever seen before. The corridors, the way they're bent, and the way the entrances work, the widths of the corridors, the way the light comes in, is all specific to this type of learning and to how these kids really need to move and socialize between those units.
We also really wanted to pay attention to the students' personal experience. So in each classroom, there you'll find a small little window that's strategically placed in the classroom. And the intent there is that it's nested with either soft seating, a rocker, or a beanbag chair as a place for students to just get away and relax.
We also have breakout rooms within the classroom. So they want to take a break and be someplace away from, even more separated from what's going on. They can go in that space and it's still okay. Or they can leave the classroom and be in our common space, which is still an okay place for them to be. We have additional spaces for students to walk or pace or move. We have an indoor playground that really helps them to get some sensory needs met.
In general, the four different communities which are designed to serve students with different needs are flexible in terms of what they have in them. So as we get students and we get their profiles, we can put them where we think that they fit best.
There's so many features of this school that are so important to not only our teachers and their work, but really impacts learning for students, because the environment can be overstimulating. many times you'll walk into classrooms in any of our schools and notice that the lights aren't on. So if we can just have natural light coming into a classroom and not have a light on, it creates a more soothing environment.
All the rules that you think of conventional planning for a school were out the window. And we were starting with a fresh approach, with fresh ideas, and really drawing from the staff.
Rather than try to make their needs fit into a typical school model, we've taken their needs and designed something very unique to what they need, and we think it's going to make a huge difference in their lives.
By specially designing a school and creating something that is welcoming, is theirs, enjoyable, comfortable, safe, I think the future for our members' children that come here is great. When you have staff that are in a good facility, staff are excited to be in a building like this. So when staff are excited, kids are excited, and the only thing we can get from that is great learning.